Can you have a successful marriage and or relationship without romance? Well, I know a lot of people who are in and out the faith are going to disagree, but and that's okay. You can do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a choice. Yeah. But my quick answer is, yeah, you can. And then I'll give scripture as we go along to, you know, tell you why. But I mean, like, where do we get this whole concept of romance anyway? You know, this tingling feeling, you're doing a whole bunch of stuff to win someone's affection. Well, I mean, we get really have it perpetrated on us through the media. It's the media that tells you what love is. I mean, like diamonds, for instance. So, I mean, who told you girls like diamonds? If a female never told you she liked diamonds, how would you know? Well, you probably would have seen it on some of these movies, some of the classic films, or even the ones known, you know what I mean? They go and they give these women the rocks, and it's like, oh my gosh, and ooh, Johnny, you know what I'm talking about? And they just gush all over you, no matter what you did, or like even flowers. What? Who told us that, that women like flowers? I know the TV told me, because most of the women I dealt with don't like flowers, bro. Maybe chocolate, but they don't really care for flowers, no? So it just kind of lets you know how we've been programmed to perceive what a relationship is. And anytime I'm talking about a marriage, I'm always talking about a pure, unadulterated, biblical marriage. Not what you all consider a marriage here in the West. I have forsaken long ago the westernized, you know, mindset and even the culture, because it's retarded. It's crazy here, man. But anyhow, I want to examine the word romance in and of itself. The etymology actually speaks volumes about it. It actually comes from the Romans, ironically enough, just like the country Romania was started by the Romans, so hence its name Romania. But when you start to examine some of these characteristics of the Romans, you start to realize they didn't know much about romance, or what they considered to be love, which is romance. And what I mean is that they were very lustful. They would have these banquets or, you know, gatherings, feasts, where they would engorge themselves with food. I mean, so they can barely walk. Then they would take delight in going to defecate out what they just ate, and then come back and have orgies. A lot of the older Roman men had an affinity for little boys, especially the Roman emperors. But they'd find them a little boy and get busy with them. Even though they could have had any woman in the kingdom, in the empire, they wanted a little boy. And in these orgies that were always done to these pagan deities, there'd be a lot of, you know, bestiality again. They would take turns having sex, men and women, with the same animal, whether it be a bull, a goat, you know, it didn't matter, man. So, pardon me. Oh, it's kind of hot in here. Yeah, so that's what they did. And it even got so bad that if you look at some of the emperors like Caligula, Nero, they dated and had full-on romances, ironically enough, with their mother, their sister, full-blooded sister. I'm not talking about like third, fourth down kissing cousins like we do in the South. I'm talking about full-blooded sisters, bruh. And when things didn't work out because they were really, really in love with them, they would kill them. Just do the research on the Romans, and you'll come to find out that they knew very little of love. If they equate romance to be love, they didn't know it. What they did know was lust. And that's what happens here in the West. You talk to a lot of these married couples who divorced after 20, 26, 30 years. It's like, damn, that's so sad. And it makes you not want to get married, because it's like, man, if they didn't make it and they wasted all the time, like, who am I? And then you ask them why, and it's typically, well, you know, the spark just went away, or, you know what I'm saying, the feeling wasn't there anymore. And you got the other part, and like, well, I was doing everything you wanted me to do. I spent less time at work. I came home. I cooked more. I gave you sex more. I did my hair like this, or I shaved down there. I mean, you can list it. No matter what kind of idiosyncratic demand the other partner had, the other partner did it in efforts to keep the marriage together, and it just wasn't enough. And it wasn't enough because that person was chasing after romance. And it's always a fleeing butterfly. I'm going to tell you something really. If that's you, if you're chasing that fluttery effect in your stomach when you first meet someone. You're going to be chasing that forever. You are at the state of a middle schooler. You might as well be writing notes, do you like me, yes or no, to somebody, because that's not love. That's not biblical love. And when you read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, you know the Apostle Paul gives us attributes of what love is. Number one, most of those attributes are verbs, meaning that love must always be shown. Love itself is a verb. Other number two, more importantly, what you don't see listed is romance. So if the Apostle Paul didn't list love as an attribute of, I'm sorry, if he didn't list romance as an attribute of love, then they have nothing to do with each other. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people here in the West, we chase that fluttery feeling. You know, when our partner goes to sleep, we hop in the inbox and da-da-da-da-da, just chasing that fluttery feeling. You know, we sneak around and do all types of stuff for that fluttery feeling. And I'm not saying that feeling is bad. I'm not saying that. I'm not even saying physical desire or attraction to someone is bad. No, that's needed. Adam seen his wife and they said that he longed after her. That's all we're saying. Damn, she was a bad bra, you hear me? So you need that. That's an attractive factor. But that should not be the ends or what your marriage is contingent off of. I tell you, no, it should not be. So again, am I about romance? Hell no. Now, can you do something nice for your wife? You take them out, you know, feet, hair, nails done, whatever. Of course, I mean, see your wife better. Yeah, no, I mean, no expense should be spared. It's your wife, man. That's your rib. You would treat her like you treat yourself. But should your marriage be the whole, should that be the whole epitome of your marriage? No, man. No, 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 no. Love, brother. Because I'm going to tell you something right now. You know, her titties may sit high like a prairie dog, but they gonna drop. It may be 10, hell, it may be 20 years from now, but they're gonna drop. I'm talking about make it bounce sixfold, low to the earth drop. They're going to drop. Can you love her then? Or you gonna be looking at somebody who like Pamela Anderson on the internet? Because it's plenty of them. And leaders, right now, if you couldn't get it up, or something happened, y'all forbid, he get hit by a car or something, he can't get his man up. I couldn't get my man up. He can get jiggy with you. What you gonna be at a therapist office talking about? Oh, I just can't. The spark isn't there. The intimacy isn't there. And I don't know. Most of you will. Because the world gives so many reasons why you should tap out and end it. Instead of sticking it out and keeping your balls. You know what I'm talking about? They make it exceedingly easy. And you can replace your spouse who you've been with and then went through so many struggles with. Just like that, with somebody who apparently looks like one of the Kardashians or maybe Nicki Minaj or something. You know what I'm talking about? I don't know, man. You know. And I'm also not saying that you shouldn't have your physical attributes that you like. Like for me, I like ass. I like ass and thighs. I'm a Popeyes man. But am I going to refuse to marry a woman because she doesn't have those physical attributes? Come on, man. That's retarded, man. We're told that in scripture, I believe it's in Proverbs 31, that, and I could be wrong, I had to go back and check it out, but that beauty is fleeting, and, you know, vain is deceit, you know what I mean? So all that stuff, at the end of the day, man, it goes away. Anyhow, I just wanted to put my 2 cents on this, and maybe you will also stop seeking out the romance and seek out the true love. I'm just saying, give it a try. Thank you.